I'm about to carry out an operation. What's the first question I should ask myself?
Is there a balloon in the patient?
Should I have taken all these selfies with the sleeping patient?
Yeah. Am I sober?
Yes.
Should I at least have a quick look on WikiHow?
So there's a list of questions.
Oh, is it? An official list.
The first thing you have to ask yourself is, do we have the right patient?
Do we have the right
patient? It's the very first question. Make sure you know which bit of the body you are going to be operating on.
I thought location meant, am I in the hospital?
Yeah. Yes.
I'm in the shed with the pliers. Is this best practice?
If it said identity and then location, location, location.
What are we doing in that location? In other words, what is the procedure that we're going to do? And did the patient, before they were conked out, say that it was OK to do this? So these are the things.
It's really basic stuff, this.
Yeah.
I thought our surgeons were kind of ahead of this stuff.
OK, so that is the extraordinary thing about it. 2008, the World Health Organization, they composed a set of 19 questions to be asked before and after all surgical operations to reduce hospital errors, and it's called the Safe Surgery Checklist. 19. And it sounds really simple, but the use of this checklist has reduced deaths by 40%. And complications by one-third.
So is that the... So before all these checks in, were there just surgeons just going, right, Brian, you're right. Come on, let's just tuck in. Come on, let's have his leg off. He looks like he could have his leg off. Come on. Next!
One surgeon who had no problem identifying the patient whatsoever was a Soviet surgeon called Leonid Rogozov. So he realised he had appendicitis, but he was visiting the Antarctic. So he had no choice but to operate on himself. Oof. So he described the pain as a snowstorm whipping through my soul, wailing like 100 jackals. I think he wrote that long after he was better, because I don't think he'd have come out with that sentence. Well, yeah.
What's it feel like, Leonid? It feels like a snowstorm.
He worked on himself for an hour and 45 minutes and he was back at work within a fortnight.
He worked on himself for an hour and 45 minutes.
Well, sorry, it's that kind of thought, Rhod, that led a man called Boston Corbett to perform self-surgery. Here is Boston Corbett. He is famous in history as the man who killed Abraham Lincoln's assassin, John Wilkes Booth. But he believed that he was very tempted by ladies and that he didn't like this, so he castrated himself with a pair of scissors.
Oh,
good action. Good action from the audience. In order to avoid temptation of prostitutes.
He cut his own testicles off with the scissors to avoid the temptation of... Why didn't he just walk down a different street?
Yes.
Thought that eunuchs were more likely to get into heaven.
I like him. I wish more men would take this path.
Every house has got scissors.
They say that delivering a child hurts as much as having your leg amputated at the thigh without any pain relief.
Who's been through those two things?
That's a bad day.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos. Well, please, come on, pick something.